about ESP.NOW protocol and also made a project for transferring the data from the master module to the slave module, and that project worked perfectly fine up to 150 meters. And in that video, I also asked one question like, what do you want to learn next in ESP.NOW protocol? And majority of you people asked me to teach two-way communication in ESP.NOW. And also some of you people even asked like whether the ESP.NOW protocol will work on ESP.266 based boards or not. So well, in this video, I'm going to teach you how to transfer data between the ESP32 board and NodeMCU board, and that too in full duplex manner. That means the two-way communication. And by the end of the video, we're making a very interesting project of controlling our home appliances using ESP.NOW protocol without having any router or internet in between. So that's the agenda of today's video. So let's quickly, let's start this video after a short ad. This video is sponsored by LTM, which is a PCB designer based software company. Now, if I tell you one very interesting feature of this software, then here in LTM Designer, you can design rigid flex PCB. Now, what is that? So till now, you must have designed the PCB, which has like rigid, like solid PCBs if you are not able to bend. But here in LTM, you can design a PCB in which some of the parts are rigid, solid, and some of the parts are flexible, which can bend, and the PCB can, you know, we can bend it in a twofold manner, just like the modern day smartphone, right? So this is a really very interesting, useful and unique feature of the software. Well, you can also try out this and many other unique and interesting features of this designer software by just clicking on the link mentioned in the description. Yes, by clicking on the link, you'll get access to the free trial version of this software. So go ahead, try out the free trial version of LTM Designer software. Okay, so coming back to this video. So let's first try to transfer the data between the ESP32 board and NodeMCU board in two-way communication manner by just sending a small string in between the boards. So let's just go on to the code side. So here is the code for both the boards. So on the left side, we have the code for the ESP32 board, and on the right side, we have the code for the NodeMCU board. And yes, these both codes have a little bit of difference, and it's just because they both are using the different libraries. So here, as you can see, we are using the ESP_now.h header file, and here we are using the ESP.now.h header file. So they both are the different header files, and with different libraries, there is a slight change of the commands used, okay? Don't worry, I'll be explaining both the codes separate, so you don't need to worry about that. So like, rather than explaining the whole code line by line, I have written the flow of that code, and with this flow I'll be explaining the code. Okay, so flow is pretty much same as we have seen in the last ESP.NOW video. So first of all, we are putting the Wi-Fi into the station mode, okay, which is done inside the setup part, which is here, and that the same step is done inside the NodeMCU part as well. So that's a pretty much same command. And after that, we are initializing the ESP.NOW both inside the ESP32 board and the NodeMCU board, which is done inside the setup part by using this particular command. And here also the command is the same, which is ESP.NOW_init. Okay, so both the commands are same, and both the flow is also the same. And the third flow is here on the ESP32 side, is adding the peer device. Okay, so here we are entering the manual MAC address to add the other ESP board, okay? And the manual MAC address is written here. Now, in case you don't know how to get the MAC address, well, you just need to upload the example code, which is provided in the description of this video. Just upload that code onto the respective board, and after uploading, when you open the serial monitor, you'll be getting this MAC address here inside the serial monitor. You just need to copy that MAC address and paste inside the code according to this format, okay? Now, make sure that you, here in the ESP32 code, you need to paste the MAC address of the NodeMCU board, and here inside the NodeMCU board, you need to paste the MAC address of the ESP32 board. Okay, so that thing you need to take care about. Okay, so like after adding this MAC address, we can easily add the peer device by, you know, following these two commands. Okay, now here inside the NodeMCU board, before adding the peer device, we need to set a role as combo. Okay, so if I take you to the setup part of the code, then here is the definition of the role. Now this is the one step extra digital to perform on the NodeMCU side. So combo means like two-way communication. Okay, straight after that, here also we are adding the peer device, and after adding the peer device, we need to define the send and receive callback functions separately. Now in the previous ESP.NOW video, we were defining either send or receive callback function. We are not defining both. It's just because that was the one-way communication, and this is the two-way communication. So we'll be sending and receiving the data. Okay, so it's a full duplex communication. For that, we need to define both the callback function, which is defined here. So send callback function is on data send, and receive callback function is on data receive. And same case, same in the case of this NodeMCU board, send callback function is on data send, and receive is on data receive. Okay, So now let's just see how we are sending the data and how we are receiving the data. Okay. So first of all, here, as you can see in the loop part, by first of all, we are, you know, storing this hello from ESP32 board inside this outgoing.message structure. Now here also one thing I missed to, you know, explain, which is the structure. Okay. So here again, we have defined the structure. Now structure is explained in the previous episode. It's like a collection of variable of same or different data types. Okay. And here I have defined exactly same structure in both the boards. Okay. So that is the must, like this is the must thing which you need to consider. Okay. You need to keep the structure exactly the same. Okay. And the structure, and this time we have defined two variables of the structure. One is the outgoing readings and second is the incoming readings. And I have defined this thing in the NodeMCU part as well, because like we'll be sending the data in the same structure and we'll be also receiving the data using that same structure. Okay. So it will be very easy to communicate between the boards. Okay. So these things you need to take care about while using the ESPNow protocol in the two-way communication. Okay. So here we are just storing this particular string in this particular variable. And after that, we are broadcasting this, what you can say, message to the broadcast address, which is nothing but the receiver's MAC address. Okay. Same goes with the NodeMCU part. We are just storing hello from NodeMCU string inside this variable and broadcasting it to the broadcast address, which is the ESP32 MAC address. Okay. Now let's just see the receiving part. So here inside the receiving part, we are first of all storing the data in the incoming reading structure. And after that, we are just printing the length of that data received and the actual message that we are receiving. Okay. And same goes with the case of the NodeMCU part. So there is a very slight change, okay, in between these codes. And yeah, that was all about the flow of the code, like how the code is working. Okay. So now what I'll do, I'll separately upload the code onto the respective boards and let us see what we're getting in response. So after uploading the code on both the boards, as you can see, I'm able to transmit and receive the data from each modules. Like this is the window for the ESP32 module and this is the window for the NodeMCU module. So yeah, with this, we have successfully learned how to transfer the data in two-way communication manner between ESP32 and the NodeMCU board. And you can do the same thing for two ESP32 boards or for two NodeMCU boards as well. Okay, so after learning this two-way communication, let us implement our learning and make our actual home automation-based project using the ESPNow protocol. And for making this project, I'll be using two of my previously made projects. First is the ESP32-based touchscreen project using which I made a smart pod previously. And second is the multiple sensors and multiple appliances project based on NodeMCU board, using which I made a small home automation project using the Blink IoT platform. And for both the projects, I designed a custom PCB and gave its order directly to GLC PCB. And well, even you can try ordering your own custom design PCBs by following very simple steps. You just need to upload the Gerber file of the PCB project on the GLC PCB platform, select the number of PCBs and color masking. And after that, just pay for your order. And if you select the fastest delivery option, well, you may get the PCBs delivered at your doorstep within a week. So try ordering your own custom designed PCBs from GLC PCB to make your projects look neat and very compact. Now, if you want to understand more the projects in detail, well, you can watch out the dedicated video whose link you can find below the like button. So after this hardware part, let us move on to the actual coding part of this project. So here's the code for the projects. On the left side, we have the code for the touchscreen model, which will be uploaded onto the ESP32 board. And on the right side, we have the code for the NodeMCU board on which the appliances and the DHT sensor will be connected. So before explaining this code, let us go through what we are actually building. Okay. So what we are doing in this project is from the ESP32 touchscreen module, we'll be sending the data of the relay models. Okay. So using the switches, we'll be controlling the relay on the NodeMCU part. And on the NodeMCU board, we also have the DHT sensor built in, which will send the temperature and humidity data directly to this touchscreen module, which is the ESP32 based board, and we'll be printing the temperature and humidity data on the screen as well. So it's a two-way communication. From this, we'll be controlling the relays, and from this, we'll be getting the sensors reading. So that was the agenda of the project. And now let's understand like how we build the code for this particular project. Okay. Starting from the touchscreen module side. So here we have necessary libraries for ESPNow as well as the touchscreen. Okay. So we are using this TFT_ESPI. Now again, let me tell you, if you want to understand both the codes and both the products in detail, you can definitely go for the dedicated video whose link is down in the description. Okay. So here we have defined the address of the NodeMCU board because we will be sending the data to that particular module. Okay. And here we have defined the calibration points because we are using the touchscreen module. Okay. So now here, let's just go to the structure part first of all. So here we have defined this structure message, which has six variables,
2 for the sensors and 4 for the respective switches, okay. As I told that you have to keep the structure same for both the cases, so in the NodeMCU part we have kept the same structure, okay. And after that, what we are doing here is talking about the touchscreen part. As soon as the particular button is pressed, what we are doing is we are sending the respective data. So in case we have pressed the switch one off button, what we are doing is we are sending the data 0 inside the switch one variable of the switch reading structure. Similar, in case we have pressed the switch two off button, we are sending the data 0 into switch two variable of the switch reading structure. Okay, so this is how we are storing the data and we are sending it using the ESP now send function. Okay, so this will send the data to the other ESP now based board. Okay, and similarly, when we are receiving the DHT census data from the NodeMCU part, it will be going into the receiver callback function, which will be defined above. So here is the receiver callback function. So we are storing all the data inside the incoming reading structure, and we are just storing the dot temperature and dot humidity value inside the temperature data and humidity data. So we are storing that variables, storing that data into separate variables. And after that, we are printing it on the serial monitor. And not only that, we are also printing the data onto the touchscreen module, which is defined inside the loop part. I'll let you know that as well. So here's the function which says print data on screen. And when I go inside the print data on screen, it is just printing the temperature data and humidity data on the respective coordinates. Okay, so that was the code for the touch screen part. It will be sending the data and receiving the data and printing onto the display. Same goes with the NodeMCU part as well. So here we have defined the same structure, and here for the sending part, what we are doing is we are first of all storing the temperature and humidity data inside the temperature variable of DHT reading structure and humidity variable of DHT reading structure respectively, and we are sending the data to the broadcast address, that means the ESP32 board. Okay, so this was all about the send data part. And in case we are receiving data from the ESP32 board, this function will be called. So first of all, we are storing all the data in the incoming reading structure, and one by one we are separating the data of the switch 1, switch 2 up to switch 4 variables, and we are printing it on the serial monitor. And not only that, we are also, you know, turning on and off that particular relay according to the switch pressed. Okay, so that was the simple code for a very useful project. So this is literally a home control, rather home automation based project, in which you can monitor sensors data, you can control appliances without any router or smartphone or hotspot or internet in between. So yeah, that was the code. Now again, I will upload the code onto the respective boards and let us see what happens next. So as you can see, I'm easily able to control appliances using this touchscreen, and that is working on the ESP Now protocol. And not only that, I'm also able to receive the real-time DHT11 sensors data, which is displayed onto the touchscreen module. And this product is a perfect example of two-way communication built using ESP Now protocol. This is really, really nice, because this whole project is working without router, without internet, and this is an example of a machine-to-machine talk. So yeah, that was all about the two-way communication using ESP. Now let me know in the comments, like, what do you want to learn next in the ESP Now protocol? Do drop your comments and I will definitely make a video just for you lovely people. That was it about this project. Do click a like button if you love this project. Also subscribe to the channel if you want to learn more such interesting thing in near future. And that being said, I'm just ending this video here and now. Just wait for my next Weather Explorer Learn Share with me, Techie SMS.